Hi everybody, doing a short video today. Thought I'd start this one from The Ink House by Rory Dubner, which, if you don't know what the book is, it looks like that. I'm going to do William DeWolf. I'm just going to pick some sections out. I'm going to pick a leaf for this wallpaper behind, and all the leaves will be coloured the same off camera. I'm going to pick part of his suit, probably do his head, and part of the seat, and see how it goes. I'm going to use Prismacolor pencils today. I have done this book before and we're using Inktense pencils and distress ink pads. Videos will be in the video list if you want to follow the Inktense ones, but this one is going to be done with all pencils, either Prismacolor pencils or Polychromos pencils, or a mixture of both. This time picking Prisma colour pencils. Right, so I'm going to zoom in and I think I'll do his face first. So let me just get the zoom. Come right in. Move the box. So, oh, camera. Move the camera. I think that'd be better. Yeah, that's focused. Okay. Oh, I'm Heather, by the way. Yeah, I do usually say at the beginning, but I forgot this time. And I can't go back to live streaming yet until I've finished having my new computer built. And seeing as I have to save up for each component, I don't know how long that's going to take to have it built. So far I'm on a small old laptop and all I can do is record short videos. So I'll start. I want to go with some espresso first. And where's my sharpener? I want a nice fine point. And so far it's blunt, as you can see. That's not going to be good enough. Sorry, my arm's getting in the way. Right, let's try that, shall we? I've got a nice fine point. That's much better. And I just want to go over the darker sections of his face, and I'm not pressing on. I just want to colour these sections a little bit darker. So I'm lightly touching the paper and just flicking it like that. And that darkens it up a little bit more. I think the fur's going this way, so I'll keep flicking it this way. And we're not building up all fur like you would if it weren't drawn in. All I'm doing is accentuating the shadow areas, making them stand out a bit more, rather than leaving dark coloured paper, which you can do, but I like to build the colour up a little bit more. So I'm just finding sections and darkening it. And you can come over it and give it more. Go over a few times, darken it a bit more. And you see that's slowly building up now. And I've still got my point because I'm only lightly touching the paper. rather than pressing on. Darken this section a little bit more. And just under his lip, but we don't want him to look like he's got muck around his face, so I'm only lightly touching it. Same under his neck. Right, we need to bring the shadow. Just there like that, and then same down this bit. Under the monocle, and we still follow the direction the fur's been drawn. You don't want to change and go opposite directions to the fur, or else it will look strange. And we don't want that. Because Rory's drawn a lot of detail into it, we're not going to put a lot of pencil on and effectively hide the detail. That's not what we're looking for, we're just enhancing it. To change colour, and I want a 30% warm grey. Again, it's blunt, so I'm going to have to sharpen it, so bear with me a second. Sharp point again. Just colouring around his snout. Into what I've put down the dog, just come below it and follow the ridge of the nose. Just coming off the edge of all these dark sections to blend it in. See, it's nice having the white, but we don't want white because he's not a white wolf, he's a grey wolf. So I'm just darkening the paper down just a little bit. And if you want him darker, you just repeat the process. Start with the espresso first, darken any areas you want to do, but don't press on, just build it up lightly. Then go with the warm grey 30% and add more shade in where you want the shadow. Like here on his nut side of his mouth, it's going to be pressed in, so it's going to cast more shadow there up to that line. So I've done this extra layer of the light grey. And the side of his nose here, just give it a bit more colour. And that's all I do, I just keep looking at the monitor, see what it looks like, and see if it needs darkening any. I think that's about it for his fur, and I will do the same on his hands. That's the only bit that's showing, and his tail over the back of the sofa. So that'll be that. And then, what colour shall I pick for the suit? About a mulberry. I've picked three colours. I've picked black grape, dahlia purple, and lavender. I'll just sharpen those. Lavender is going to be the lightest colour. So I'm going to put that down first. And the dahlia purple. The black grape. the Dahlia purple. Just slowly keep building the colour up like that. I'm back. I've got a diazepine purple yellow, dioxazine purple yellow. I've gone over the darker areas and put some blue into the purple. And just random areas to look like there's shadow hitting. It gives it more rounded shape to that colour. Alright, so I'm gonna do some of this side piece just to show you how I'll build the colour up. So I've gone with the grape again and put it where the darkest areas is going to be, which will be just under the lapel. I'm not pressing on, I'm only putting a light tone. Under the buttons. Use of the arm. With the Dahlia purple. We'll put all the colour codes that I've used down below underneath the video. With a list of colours. Lavender. Okay, so that's each colour tone quickly laid down. And then I want to start building the colour up again. So back to the grape. And this is where I start doing little fine lines rather than laying colour down quick and then darkening the shading first. The Dahlia purple. I'm going over the grape and pulling it out. Just little bits. Turn it out again. And back to the lavender. I'm blending off the Dahlia purple into the centre. with the dioxazine purple hue. Just gonna mucky it down a little bit. Just putting the odd line in. Following what's been drawn. With the lavender and blend it in. So all the suit will be done like that. That. Right, thief. Sandbar brown and kelp green. So I'm going with sandbar brown first, and again, just following the darkest lines and putting a very light tone of the sandbar brown, which is like a green brown mix. The kelp green. I'm overlapping the sandbar brown and covering the rest of the white with the kelp green. back to the sandbar brown. Kelp green, and I'm going to blend that in little circles all over the leaf. That gives it a nice rich green. I'm just going to go with the sandbar brown again, just in the darkest areas.
How are you doing with chops? Do you want me to put them in slow cooker?
If you want. I don't know if they're fully defrosted yet.
You defrosted, yeah, but I can stick them on slow for now, can't I?
Yes. Right, I want cream for the centre. So, green light, I think. Second. Okay, so continue leaves like that is suit. I'll carry on like that. This fur will probably darken a little bit more. Now the light's hitting it, it looks a bit too light, but it's the same two colours. Warm grey 30 and espresso. And I'll be back when I've finished those. Until next time, take care.